I'm Dr. Akhil Ranjan Dutta. I teach political science at a university called Guwahati University. It's in the state of Assam, northeastern region of India. I'm involved in people's rights movement, and in the process I have started questioning the dominant paradigms of development, dominant discourses on rights, democracy, so on and so forth. You know, the right that we talk about, nation that we talk about, or state that we talk about have basically been borrowed from the European context. But we have seen various movements in different parts of the world, in the third world countries, and all these movements have started questioning the dominant notion of development, dominant notion of modernization, dominant notion of national state system, and so on and so forth. So it has been, in a way, these movements in the third world countries have been questioning the very notion of civilization. It has taught us one thing, that, and it should be learned by the European world, Europe, that civilization cannot be imported. Civilization cannot be installed in different, you know, contexts without looking into or without taking into account the dynamics of those societies itself. I remember famous Nigerian novelist Chinua Achebe, who had written that famous novel, Things Fall Apart. If you try to impose something, whether it is civilization or religion or a system of government, in another context, without looking into how the history of those societies have evolved, what is the civilization of those societies itself, it will only, you know, create a kind of destruction, and people will be revolting against it. I think that is one of the very important notion, important thing that Europe should learn from the resistance movements, or popular movements, or people's movements, which are taking place in the third world countries. The second one, and that is very critical, that modernization is not a one-dimensional process. Modernization is not something homogeneous. Modernization can have different, you know, different approaches itself. Modernization doesn't necessarily mean importing what is being called modernization in the European context. For example, we have a society here, tribal societies, where we think in, when we talk about property, we think in terms of community property, community ownership of property. But in the European context, the societies which have evolved from feudalism to capitalism, where right to private property is considered to be a sacred right, that individual ownership of property hasn't been emphasized upon. But in the tribal societies, in the context of India, in the context of particularly northeastern region, tribal societies, notion of property is communitarian. That communitarian ownership of property itself could be a variant of modernization. I think these are some of the important things that Europe should learn from the other world, other countries in the world. Thank you.